Washington State Emergency Management is to help residents and visitors prepare for and respond to disasters such as tsunamis. Another role is also to issue official warnings. This is done through the emergency alert system as well as the all hazard alert broadcast or AHAB siren system that's located along the outer coast. Residents and visitors to Washington State need to be prepared to react to and respond to the different types of warnings that would be issued. For example, in a local Cascadia subduction zone event, the natural warning signs such as the ground shaking or water receding away from the shoreline may be your only warning. In those instances, you need to be prepared to move to inland or to high ground immediately. From a distant event, such as one that would occur in Alaska or Japan, for example, there'll be more time to issue official warnings. These would be issued via the emergency alert system, NOAA Weather radio, or Washington State's all hazard alert broadcast or AHAB sirens. These sirens will produce an official warning tone that alerts those in the outdoor areas to evacuate and move inland or to high ground immediately.
Here at the Washington State Alert and Warning Center, tsunamis are one of the hazards we're concerned about. One of the first indicators of an earthquake or tsunami event will be from the California Integrated Seismic Network. We'll usually get a visual and audio alarm as to where and when and the magnitude of the earthquake in question. That's one of our first indicators. Immediately following that, we'll get two messages, one from the Washington State Patrol Access messaging system, and at the same time, we'll also get a message from our email alert system. Once we receive our messages, we'll get a call from the West Coast Alaska Tsunami Warning Center via the National Alert and Warning System, or NAWAS, phone circuit.
This is the Washington Warning Point, loud and clear.
We have two phone circuits, the national circuit and the state circuit. The Tsunami Warning Center will call us on the national circuit. We'll respond to that. We'll take down all the pertinent information and immediately activate the state circuit and contact the counties that are most likely affected, which are either four coastal counties or or 14 inland counties.
This is the Washington Warning Point. The preceding ring was for Clallam County, Jefferson County, Grays Harbor, and Pacific County. Other stations disregard. I say again, this
is the Washington affected counties are notified via the National Alert and Warning System network, we activate the Alert and Warning System message to alert the general population. And from here, we can type up the message and send it out, and that'll go to various news agencies who will in turn retransmit the message to television and radio. While the emergency alert system messages are transmitted from our duty positions, we have a backup system that has pre-selected messages that we can use in case our primary system fails. One example of a tsunami message is already preloaded.
A tsunami warning has been issued for the coastal areas of Washington.
Once a tsunami warning message is received, one of the duty officers here at the Alert and Warning Center will come to the AHAB, that's All Hazards Alert Broadcasting System, and will activate the sirens. And then depending on what areas are affected, we have three pre-selected messages that we could transmit that will activate the sirens on the coast.